accepted tranquility, then preached and practiced the gospel of love and tolerance. This propagates the vision and mission of Mahatma. With these words, I request the head of our department, Dr. Gauri Boy, to deliver welcome address. Please, ma'am.
Good morning and warm greetings to you all in this wonderful day. Especially this day is considered as red-lettered even in the history of the Department of History, Nesamani Memorial Christian College, Marthandam. We are so proud to welcome the principal correspondent, the chief guest of the day, organizing secretary, all the participants and the professors in this happiest occasion. I'm very glad to welcome. First of all, I am grateful to the Lord for providing such a good opportunity in our department. Especially thy presence we need till the end of this webinar. So I bow my guts to greet and welcome thy presence in this great day. The day is very important because our nation is going to celebrate the Platinum Jubilee of our Independence Day. So on account of this Independence Day, our department is arranging such good webinar, national webinar. In this August occasion, I'm grateful to say a word, that is the day 5th of August, as a prerequisite for the recollecting of the great father of our nation, Gandhiji's views to be fulfilled in the midst of the nation as well as the whole world. Because the whole world is waiting for peace. Today, the pandemic situation as well as the ideas behind the leaders that creates peace in the situation. But we need peace. So this webinar will help all the participants to rethink or to recollect or to revisit the thoughts, great thoughts left by Mahatma Gandhi in the form of ahimsa, nonviolence, non-cooperation, etc., etc., that we are going to hear from the mouth of the great personality today, the chief guest. So I'm going to do my duty regarding the welcome. First of all, it's my responsibility to welcome the most reputed principal of our college, Dr. K. Pal Raj, an inspiring personality, to arrange such webinars during this pandemic situation. Sir, we are so happy to welcome on behalf of the Department of History and my own behalf. Welcome and thank you, sir. Okay. Next, I'm very proud to welcome the correspondent of our college, Advocate L. Rajadurai, always a motivating person to organize such programs. So I welcome Advocate L. Rajadurai, our correspondent also. Next, it's my pleasure to welcome our chief guest, Dr. Pankaj Singh, Assistant Professor, Department of History, Dr. Harishingav Vishwavidyalaya, Central University, Sagar, Madhya Pradesh. Actually, by seeing his biodata, Dr. G.M. Sundar Sari is going to introduce a lot about him. By seeing his biodata itself, I can understand that he is a renowned personality, as young and energetic person, throughout India, especially the young historian of today. The professor is going to highlight about the great ideals or the thoughts of Mahatma Gandhi. The theme itself reflects that, how he is possessing a good inspiration about the expectation of Gandhi. So I welcome, sir, on behalf of the Department of History and my own behalf. Next, I am very proud to welcome the organizing secretary of the program, Dr. G.M. Sundar Singh, sir, for arranging such a good webinar in this pandemic situation. Especially, I feel as a proud to the Department of History, because we are going to celebrate, that is the Platinum Jubilee of our Independence Day within a short span, that is August 15th. So before that, we plan to conduct a national webinar related to the topic, apt topic, what we need today. So this is a need of the hour in this scenario. He has arranged such a good topic to conduct us in the form of webinar. Sir, on behalf of my own behalf and on behalf of the department, I welcome you, sir, for your initiative. It's my pleasure to thank also. Welcome you, sir. Next, I'm welcome to Dr. J. Evangeline Sheila Bell, the coordinator of the program. Always an inspirational figure for the arrangements of such programs in the department. Her prayers and her support and always gives enthusiasm to not only the myself, all the professors. Ma'am, on behalf of my own and all the professors of the department, I welcome you, ma'am. Next, I would like to welcome all the eminent professors of our department, especially they are acting as pillars of the department. So each and every individual professor is responsible for the success of the department. So the organizing, in the name of organizing committee, they are playing a vital role. Yes, today, a very important day, all the professors, they are joined. So I welcome you on my own behalf and also our own department behalf. Okay, welcome you all. Next to the IQAC coordinator, as well as the members who are supporting for the starting of this program. Next, it's my pleasure to welcome the professors of other departments of our college, as well as the participants from various colleges. Professors are there. So it's my pleasure to welcome all the professors of our college department, as well as other departments of various colleges, especially HD department professors from various colleges joined. So on behalf of my own and on behalf of the department, I welcome you all. Next, it's my pleasure to welcome all the participants, especially the research scholars, MPhil, PhD students, and all the UG students also. I feel that this webinar will inspire all the scholars as well as the eminent persons who has joined in this webinar, because we should rethink, we should recollect, we should react. Not only thinking and collecting, we should react for providing art to the fulfillment of a dream of our nation's father of our nation, Mahatma Gandhi. So I once again, I welcome all the participants, the chief guest, as well as all the participants, welcome you all, and I express my thanks also. Okay, thank you and welcome.
Thank you, madam. Welcome you to this program, ma'am. Yes, now I request the backbone of our college, our respected principal, Dr. K. Paul Raj, to deliver the presidential address. Please, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Most respected and beloved secretary of our college, Advocate L. Rajagurai. Resource person of the today's webinar, Dr. Pankaj Singh, Assistant Professor of History, Central University, Madhya Pradesh. Head of the Research Center of History Department, Dr. Glory Bhai Mehta. Senior most faculty who is coordinating this today's webinar, Dr. Evangeline Sheila Bell. Organizing Secretary, Dr. Sundar Singh, moderator of the today's webinar, Dr. Edward Sam, IPSC coordinator of our college, Professor T.B. Thomas, who is arranging the technical support. Organizing committee members who are the members of the history department of our college. Faculty members, research scholars, and students who are attending this today's webinar. Good morning to all of you. I welcome you all on behalf of the Nesamani Memorial Christian College, Marthanda. During this pandemic situation, our institution is also not behind for conducting or executing all the academic activities. Especially under the collaboration or cooperation of the IPAC of our college, many departments, especially research departments, periodically conducting online programs, either as webinars, workshops, faculty development programs, quizzes, etc., etc. Department of History, one of the oldest department of our college, having maximum strength, not only in the form of students, but also academic enrichment, academic production of our college. Today, they're arranging the webinar, Revisiting Gandhian Thoughts in 21st Century. I surprised and wondered the term Revisiting Gandhian Thoughts. I'm not accepting for this particular topic because the Kantian thoughts, especially truth, non-violence, sarvodaya, satyagraha, four pillars of the Kantian thoughts, every day we have to follow. All these four pillars should be the part and parcel of our every human being. So that I mentioned, it is not a revisiting, but every day we have to follow these principles of the Mahatma Gandhi, because Mahatma Gandhi, not only our father of nation, but he's one of the great leader of the world level. Each and every citizen of, that is global citizen, will accept the principles of the Mahatma Gandhi. As I mentioned earlier, the truth that is ever living, every person should possess the quality of the truth. The lies cannot withstand or will not stabilize, will not give peace to the human beings. Every person should have the truth in every aspects, whether academic aspect, religious aspect, family aspect, social aspect, in each and every place, truth only bring victory. That taught by or teaching by our great leader, Mahatma Gandhi. Similarly, non-violence in our society, every day we can see through the various media, various incidents happen in the world. Terrorism, one of the important aspects because of the so many reasons. But our leader Mahatma Gandhi taught we should follow the non-violence. By that principle only, we got the freedom from the British people. That also we should remember. That another important pillar, That is Sarvodaya. That is development in the field of education, economic and social. Mahatma Gandhi, his philosophy highlighted especially the development of the educational development of the India, economic development of the India, as well as social development of the India. Then another term, important term, Satyagraha, salt Satyagraha, different type of non-cooperative activities against the British government he taught us and he achieved. But due to the shortage of time, I am not going to give the details in each and every aspect because of a resource person is waiting for delivering his thoughts and ideas. Anyway, this Department of History very successfully arranging this national webinar, as the other Department of History, Dr. Glory Boy mentioned, the participants all over from India attending this webinar, very much waiting the words from Dr. Pankaj Singh. I thank all the organizers, especially faculty members of History Department, the technical support or the arrangement by the Professor T.P. Thomas, who is the IQC coordinator, and also the participants attending this webinar. Once again, I thank our resource person for sharing his valuable time for the benefit of our faculty members, our research scholars, also our students. At the end of the seminar, definitely the participants will get some new vision or new ideas regarding the Gandhian thoughts in the present 21st century. Have a nice day. Thank you. Thank you, Anantha.
Just like we explained about Gandhi and his visions, thanks for that. Next, I request the master brain of this program, Dr. G.M. Sundar Singh, to introduce our chief guest of the day. Sir.
Most respected correspondent of our premier and prestigious institution, Advocate Rajadurai. Honorable principal of our institution, Dr. K. Palraj. An eminent head of the department, Dr. M. Glory Boy. The coordinator of this program and the senior most professor of our department, Dr. Evangeline Sheelabel, the moderator of our program, an enthusiastic professor, Dr. Edwin Sam, most beloved faculty members of our department, the faculty members from other department and the participants. It's my bound duty to introduce the resource person of this webinar entitled Revisiting Gandhian Thoughts in the 21st Century. Related with the resource person, I have to tell a few words about Dr. Pankaj Singh. He was one of the remarkable personality of Madhya Pradesh. He reached the zenith of his popularity only through his hard work. He got a chance first to deliver the lecture in our state, Tamil Nadu, especially in the southernmost tip, that is Kanyakumari. He was closely associated with me, related with the name Singh. He is Pankaj Singh and myself is Sundar Singh. By the name itself, we became friends. Related with him, he was a very good teacher. He was a person in specialization in Gandhian thoughts and in medieval and modern history. He has published more than 25 articles in reputed journals. He is a life member of Indian History Congress, Madhya Pradesh History Congress. He was also a convener for organizing various webinar in the Dr. Hari Singh Gaur Vishwavidyalaya, that is a central university in Madhya Pradesh. He was a regular class teacher for teaching history for competitive examinations in his university. Before 1 year, he was a course coordinator of one of the refresher course which was arranged by the HRDC in Dr. Hari Singh Gaur Vishwavidyalaya in Madhya Pradesh. He was guiding several research scholars. He was an enthusiastic and energetic professor who is going to deliver a very good lecture which will be more useful for our faculty members as well as our department. Sir, your presence in our midst, it's a great proud for us. On behalf of myself, our Department of History, Nesamani Memorial Christian College, Marthandam, I welcome you, sir. Thank you for your presence in our midst. Thank you. Thank you, Onanda.
Thank you, Sundar Singh, sir, for your good words. Now I welcome a respected resource person, Dr. Pankaj Singh, to deliver keynote address. Please, sir.
Thank you, sir, for inviting me. Am I audible?
Yes, you are audible, hello. Sir.
Thank you so much. And welcome to everyone. And good morning to all of you. And I am very much feeling honored to be here with you all. And first of all, most respected principal, sir, Dr. K. Paul Raj, and respected guest, Advocate N. Rajadurai Sarji, and head of the department, History, Dr. M. Glory Bai, ma'am, coordinator of the program, C. Label, and Dr. Edwin Sam, the moderator of the program, and all the organizing committee of Neshamani Memorial Christian College. And I'm thankful to IQAC, the team who is providing us the technical support. And really, it's a wonderful moment for me to be with you for this discussing on Gandhi. I am thankful to Dr. Sundar Singh, one of my best good friend, and maybe the first friend from South India. And just 1 year back, we are sharing a program in refresher course, and we become friends. First of all, before starting my lecture, I just want to say that I am not good in English. So please pardon me if I say something wrong grammatically or vocabularily. I am not very good, and this is my first experience to talk to you people. And because we belongs to Hindi belt, Madhya Pradesh, the heart of India. So many communications which we are delivering, that is in Hindi. And there shall be some mistakes. So please, first of all, I apologize for that mistake. And let me clear one thing, that I am not the expert of Gandhian thought. I am the believer of Gandhian thought. I just want to say that I do practice Gandhian thoughts in my life, day-to-day life. And I just want to say one thing, why the question arises from my childhood, why he is called father of the nation, why he is called Mahatma, why he is called Bapu. The question again and again come to my mind, and I just, after completing my graduation, and that then I started to study Gandhi. Then I find that after independence, after 72, 71 year of independence, we have forgotten Gandhi. Yes, I do agree with Principal Sir that the word revisiting is something clicking in mind. Why revisit? We have to face all these things, truth, non-violence, satyagraha, sarvodaya in our day-to-day life. So why we have to revisit? Because I think it is the high time to revisit the Gandhian thought. Because everywhere, if we think after 70 years of independence, nowhere Gandhian thought is live. We just ceremonially celebrate the Gandhi on 2nd of October and 30th of January every year. After that, we just forgot. And in 1969, when the photograph of Gandhi is on currency of our Indian currency, then it is very common that Gandhi is in our currency, in 100 rupees note, 500 rupees note. Apart from that, where is Gandhi? Where is Gandhi's India? What he was dreaming about India? Is it that India? Friends, I will also show a PowerPoint presentation. That is not, I don't think it is needed, but I just want to show that presentation. And in between, I will also go through some present time database that will show why we have to revisit Gandhi. And before starting my lecture, I just want to share my screen. If it is visible, then please tell me. Is it visible? Sir, yes, screen sir. Is visible?
Yes, sir. Yes.
PowerPoint is visible, no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, I just go to the next slide. Is it visible, sir? Second slide? Because I...
Yes, visible, sir.
Okay. There we can find the slogan that in a gentle way, you can save the world. That is the... that is the power of Mahatma Gandhi, that without any machine gun, without any gun, he has just shown the path to the whole world. And these all things are not new. And he always, Gandhi always admit that whatever his idea is, not his own idea. He has just taken these all ideas from ancient time. He has taken all these ideas. Ideas from ancient texts from all over the world, not from India, not from Bhagavad Gita. It is from Bible also. He was very much influenced with the Bible. He was influenced with the Bhagavad Gita, and he has taken all his ideas from all the great texts of the world. And he was influenced by Leo Tolstoy, John Ruskin, Thoreau, and even in India, if you can say, he's highly influenced by Mahatma Buddha and Mahavir Swami. And when he is going for the studying the Bible, and he was very much influenced with the life of Jesus Christ. And and I can say Gandhi has influenced, Mahatma Gandhi has influenced over all the over the Indian culture, thought, and politics so deeply. It's made not possible for everyone to determine the right value for all his contribution. Really, this line shows that he has influenced our life, the whole culture, thought, and politics so deeply that we cannot ignore him, and we cannot determine the right value of his contribution. But still, we have to talk today about why we have to revisit Gandhi. And the things which have been said that I have already told you that Gandhiji proposed the self-force, Atmabal. In Hindi, if we say self-force, Atmabal, instead of brutal force, that is Pashubal. And he has shown the due to poor connectivity, sir, I just left. Sir, again, I am sharing my screen.
Yes, yes, you can share, sir.
Sir, is it showing, sir?
Yes, sir.
Sir, screen is visible?
Yes, 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 sir.
Excuse me, sir, I think, yeah.
Please let me know if because I just I am going through the PPTs. I am not seeing the whole screen, so that is why the problem is there. Just I am going through these slides. This is next slide which I am. Sir, this I just go through the first line. Gandhi is known worldwide as political leader. This line is showing, sir. He was also renowned theorist, philosopher, practitioner of truth, non-violence, and tolerance and freedom. Sir, this is.
Sir, you are in the third slide.
There is some problem. Ask to unmute. Sir, am I audible? Extremely sorry because due to my technical problem, I just again. And I'm coming to the next slide. This is the fourth, fifth slide. I'm just going through this slide. And hello. Hello.
Yes, you are
audible, sir. Am I audible?
Yes, you are audible.
Hello. Sundar sir, I am audible. If I am
Yes, sir. Yes. Your voice is breaking.
Okay. Oh, so there is some technical issue, sir. This is next slide where we can see the main ideas of Gandhiji. Sir, I'm extremely sorry. There is a connectivity issue here. So that it is heavy raining outside, and maybe it is poor connectivity. That is why my voice is not coming. This is the whole idea of Gandhiji: truth, non-violence, satyagraha, tolerance, Gram Swaraj, trusteeship, women empowerment, basic education, Swadeshi, and Sarvodaya. All these ideas were given by Gandhiji, and most of the ideas, the truth and non-violence, it is not new to us from Buddha to Mahavira and all these great saints of India. Have given these ideas, but in the practical manner, it was the first time that Gandhiji, who has managed truth and non-violence to the weapon as a weapon of common man, arm level, and it is.
Pankaj sir, you are muted. Kindly unmute your microphone. You are not audible.
Sir, now it is okay, sir.
Yeah, now it is fine, sir. Now it's fine. Yeah. You can go ahead, sir.
Okay. I'm sorry. I have told you. Okay. Sir, I was there that Gandhi has, before Gandhiji, if we talk about the Indian National Movement, Indian Freedom Movement, if you see from before 1915, there was no such mass movement where the all sections or cross-sectional participation was there. No, the farmers, the laborers, the women. And after when Gandhiji entered in our politics, and his politics was altogether different. He has proved his politics, his political weapons, satyagraha and truth and non-violence in South Africa for a long, long time. And he was very successful. And after the invitation of Gopala Krishna Gokhale, he just came to India. And first 2 years, he has not joined politics, the active politics. But after 2 years, he visited within 2 years, 1915 to 1970, he visited the whole India. Then he realizes the problems of Indian people, problem of India. What is he just not felt that we are governed by the British government. We are under the colonial government. He also realized that the reality is that
अरे कनेक्शन बहुत खराब हो रहा है, बार बार कट जा रहा है, बहुत दिक्कत हो रहा है. एंड दिस आफ्टर नॉन वायलेंस एंड ट्रुथ आई कम टू द पॉइंट सत्याग्रह एंड सर्वोदय एंड दिस इज द मेथड नॉन वायलेंट मेथड व्हिच ही प्रूव दैट. Extremely sorry because due to poor network again and again I lost the connection. Truth and non-violence, and if we he has shown the new way, and satyagraha he was started in 1906 in South Africa, and injustice, inequality, oppression and exploitation, this method can be used. But the first condition of the satyagraha is that your demand should be legal, your demand should be truthful. If you are really aggrieved of injustice or exploitation, then only you can use this tool. And this was the very effective tool during the whole freedom movement. And even today, we see the human rights movement, women empowerment movement, and in the whole world, we are just looking that satyagraha movement is very powerful, and still it is effective. And next point is the Sarvodaya, his idea of Sarvodaya, the universal uplift, progress of all. And this was the idea of Gandhi, that in this, if you go through the Sarvodaya, you will feel that he was
he was in the mind that he just want to uplift all the people who are downtrodden, who are exploited, and who are the last man of the society. He was thinking about the last man of the society, and that was the great idea. And he was very much influenced by the John Ruskin's his book. When he gone through his book Unto This Last, he started the new idea Sarvodaya. And this Sarvodaya idea is nowhere, we are not finding today in anywhere India. That is why I said ki why we have to revisit. I will come to the point of the economic policy and today's economic policy. I will correlate the Gandhi of today's world, and coming to the next slide. And next point is the Swaraj. These are the core ideas of Gandhiji. And if we think the Swaraj means independence, so I don't think Gandhiji meant that. Gandhiji's Swaraj means the state of the last man, the poorest people. And that Swaraj means you have all the people feel free, and they have the proper food. They have their home. They have their all the rights. Then only we get the Swaraj. And even today, after 70 years of independence, I can say most of our people have not found their Swaraj. We are having the same corruption, same exploitation, same discrimination we are feeling. A lot of people of India, we can say 30-40% of our population is still aggrieved, and they are not feeling that this is their Swaraj. Still, yes, we are independent. Yes, we are independent. But the problem is that we don't have Swaraj. Swaraj means self-rule. Where is self-rule? I will ask... coming to the next point also, this is also one of the idea of Gandhiji, that in Gandhian philosophy, the trusteeship. And trusteeship is one of the, somebody can say the trusteeship is the utopia of Gandhi, and it is a superficial idea of Gandhiji, but not, it is not. He just say that all the industrialist or capitalist should be the trustee of the people. They will serve the people. They will serve the people. Just we have only one or two examples in India. Just Ajim Premji Foundation, that one of he is charitating maximum 90% of his income to the people, and he is running on the Ajim Premji Foundation all over India in tribal areas, and he is working for that. But we can count this type of industrialist, one or two men, but we have and we don't see much people are coming forward for this idea, because this is the core idea of Gandhiji, trusteeship. And I will talk to you all of you regarding this in next slide also. And now the word Swadeshi, and this Swadeshi actually, Swadeshi means the production from the our own people, and it is the focus within the Swadeshi is one's own country, but we usually translate it is most countries self-sufficiency. And Swadeshi is the focus on acting within from one's own community, both politically and economically. It is the interdependence of the community and self-sufficiency. Friends, these I have gone through mainly three or four, five ideas: truth, non-violence, Swaraj, Satyagraha, trusteeship, and Swadeshi. And after that, the next slide, which I am going to show you, it will when I will show it, if you will go through this this graph, you can understand why we have to rethink, why have to revisit Gandhian thoughts. If you go through this World Global Hunger Index, I am just going through this. This is not my data. This is provided by the international agency, the World Global Hunger Index. Every year, this agency shows the parameters, and we are now at 94th position out of 107 countries. This index has been surveyed in 107 countries, and we are at 94th position. And you can see Nepal at 73rd position, and Bangladesh at 25th place. Pakistan, can you imagine that Pakistan is an 88th rank and we are 94. We are far behind of Nepal, Bangladesh, Pakistan. So we can say what is the condition of the development of India after 70 years of independence. We cannot provide the maximum people, the minimum requirement, that is food. And this graph is showing the condition of India. Friends, you can understand where we are. These are the questions which I am going to show in two or three slides. And if you will go through this. Now I will come with the Human Development Index. Human Development Index, if you go through the out of 189 countries, India is 131 position. And Human Development Index is showing the education, inequality, gender gap, and all these type of infrastructure development and all these type of parameters, we are 131 place. And every year we are declining. Here you can see -2. That means in 2018, we are 129th place. And in 2019, in Human Development Index, we are 131. It shows that we have not provided the maximum people to the minimum infrastructure, food, drinking water facility, and education, and the matter of discrimination and inequality. These are the things which the question arises, why we have to talk about Gandhi. Next. And this is the data from Social Justice Ministry website. I have taken it. And this is the government data. And reality is something different from it. And the reality is that the government data says that 27.5% of population of India is under below poverty line. Can you imagine? And India, the Social Justice Ministry had said that if a person from a rural area who is earning 356 rupees per month is poor, and the person who is earning 538 rupees 60 paisa per month is in urban area is poor. And you can believe that the 27.5% of population is under poverty line, below poverty line. And this is the harsh reality. This is the harsh reality of our development. And it shows that we are being independent since 71, 72 years. Friends, these three graphs which I have shown on the Human Development Index, Global Hunger Index, and finally, the population below poverty line. That is, it shows why we have to revisit Gandhi, why we have to talk about Gandhi, and why we have to talk about the Gandhian thoughts. So I'm coming to the next points. And now I am saying about things that what is the global relevance today, and why, what are the global relevance of Gandhian of non-violence, and in this matter, in this regard, not only in India, from the world leaders like Martin Luther King Jr., Mark, Nelson Mandela, Dalai Lama, Desmond Tutu, and all the Gandhian thoughts. And I quote one or two great personalities, Martin Luther King Jr., who was the who has fought whole life for the discrimination between black and white. He was the leader of racial discrimination in America, and he was also shot dead. He was killed by some extremist. And Martin Luther King, he was highly influenced by Gandhi. And he said that intellectuals and moral satisfaction that I could not find in Bentham. And Mill's utilitarianism, Marx and Lenin's revolutionary theories, and Rousseau return to nature, concept and optimism. And it's a superhumanist philosophy. That means Martin Luther King did not find what he want to achieve. But when he find Gandhian non-violent philosophy, I received. That means, that he find everything from Gandhian thought and Gandhian way of non-violence. And another one leader, American leader, the Chavez, Charles Chavez, and he said about Gandhiji, the great American leader, and what he said, not only discussed the non-violent movement, but also told the world how nonviolent means bring us closer to such ends as justice and liberation. And this is the remarks by the American civil rights movement leader, Charles Chavez. And Tibetan leader Dalai Lama, you all know the Nobel Prize winner, and the Dalai Lama had said that many ancient masters have preached the philosophy of ahimsa, nonviolence. But that was not just philosophical understanding, but Gandhi was the one who had to put this sophisticated thought into practice and applied it in modern politics so that his country can achieve independence, which is a great thing. And I have greatest admiration of Mahatma Gandhi, and he was a great human being with a deep understanding of human nature, and his life has inspired me. And this is the statement by the Dalai Lama. Sundar sir, am I audible? Because I'm going through the slides.
Yes, sir. You are audible.
Okay. Thank you, sir. And we can understand. I have just gone through two or three slides what the great leaders of the world have said for the Gandhiji. And you all know this famous statement by Albert Einstein. Who introduced the magical E is equal to MC square, the formula of unlimited energy, atom bombs. You can understand the Einstein, what Einstein said, I believe that Gandhi's views were the most enlightenment. Things in his spirit, not to use violence in fighting for our cause, but non-participation in anything you believe is evil. Generations, and again he said in another statement, generations to come will scare believe that such a one of us as this ever in flesh and blood walked upon this earth. That means what? And you will amaze that there is a great bonding between Albert Einstein and Gandhi, and they wrote later to each other. They corresponded their letter with each other, and finally, I will say about Barack Obama, the ex-president of United States of America, that when he visited India to the Indian Parliament, and then he said, "I am greatly influenced by a man from your nation. The message of love and justice shows us the way ahead, just as he, that is Gandhi, summoned Indians to seek their destiny. He influenced champions of equality in my own country." I think somebody have mute their mic because the voice is... Okay. Thank you. So Barack Obama was highly influenced by Gandhi, and he just said that he influenced the champions of equality in my own country, including Martin Luther King Jr. And Dr. King called Gandhi's philosophy of nonviolence and resistance as the only logical and moral approach in the struggle for justice and progress. This was the word by the Barack Obama. And Barack Obama, once a student of class 9th in America, when he visited to a school, that girl asked Barack Obama, "Mr. President, if you have a chance to dinner with some eminent personality of 100 years back, to whom do you want to have a lunch or dinner with him or her?" So Barack Obama said, "Oh, the list is quite bigger, but I can definitely say that that will be the Mahatma Gandhi, to whom I want to take the lunch or dinner." That was the inspirational force for Barack Obama. And Barack Obama had admitted a lot of time, if Gandhian thoughts were not, if he was highly influent, if Gandhi is not there, then it is really impossible for him to come to that, because he know Gandhi has shown the path that without any weapon, we can fight with the inequality. And same thing, the Martin Luther King Jr. and Nelson Mandela in his country, they have fought all their struggle with the weapon of the Gandhi. And one interesting, another interesting statement by Vietnamese revolutionary freedom fighter Ho Chi Minh, he said, the line is very interesting. "I and others may be revolutionaries, but we are disciples of Mahatma Gandhi, directly or indirectly. Nothing more, nothing less." How true it is. If you go through this statement, and do you know that Ho Chi Minh is the leftist leader, and he was a revolutionary, and he believed in arms and violence. But at the end of his life, he said that "I and other maybe revolutionaries, but we are disciples of Mahatma Gandhi, directly or indirectly, nothing more, nothing less." Then he has influenced that type of leader also. And Daiku Deku, the Japanese Buddhist leader, he also says that Gandhi's activism was not a mere action, but a spiritual practice that is roused by the strict urge to the power of consciousness. This is some statements I have collected from internet and some books, and I have just bring to you because we can understand the value of non-violence movement all over the world. And this is a study by two professors, Professor Erica Chenoweth and Maria S. Stephen of Howard Kennedy School. And they have gone through 323 people's movement over the last 100 years. And now what the study shows that, I will come to the next slide. If you see the pie chart, you will see that this area is the violent movement. And this is 26%. And this, the big pie chart, which is showing in orange, reddish orange color, that is non-violent movement. That means, I'm just coming to the previous slide. This slide, that you will find that 323 people's movement have been out of the 323 people's movement, 175 movement of non-violent movement were successful. 175 movements were successful, and only 75 or 78 the violent movement were successful. And that shows that the non-violent movements are twice more successful bringing out the change in comparison with the violent movement. And this is the source, the power. And after this success rate has increased steadily after 1940, after Second World War. After Second World War, the Gandhian mode of movement have been more successful after Second World War. This shows that the idea, this idea that the The relevance of Gandhian ideas from the above facts is clear that non-violence has more power to bring about change than violence. And this is all about the non-violence, what I have to say. And this is slide is coming two or three slides are something serious, which I want to say that like the words which I have written in the slide, that the, like the basic tendencies in the Western civilization, the progress and development has taken place due to greed, exploitation, and inhuman forms of power. Gandhiji considered is anti-human and threat to the whole world. You all know that Gandhiji's famous quote that we have, the nature have everything for our need. Nature and earth have everything for our need, but friends, it is not for our greed, not enough for our greed. That is the reality. And the reality is that we are copying the Western civilization, that civilization is materialistic. And if we gone through that that ideas, that we will surely we will collapse ourselves in coming years. And Gandhiji says that the things which have given the shape of a system or system to such developments and progress, Gandhiji is standing against them and tries to liberate man and society from it. And Gandhiji knew that the modern process of expansion and colonialism is sponsored by the dazzle of foreign knowledge, science, we will only by the recipients of it, we will never get the opportunity to become the creators. We are copying the West. We are not doing nothing. And what they are doing, we are just copying. And that is the big problem. And if we are copying to the West, we have to see that we have a larger, more population than them. And we have another culture, we have another problems, which the West don't have. So that is why Gandhiji's effort was to remove the global illusion of modernity and find a place where we can become the heroes of our modernity. And Gandhiji said that we can see from the study of history that the centralization, that the modern centralized mode of production gave rise to the authoritarianism and authoritarianism in political field. At the same time, its concept also rejects values like liberty, equality, and social justice. And friends, I will come to the, I will also describe all the things that when we have adopted the policy of globalization in 1990s. Really, we can say that we have developed a lot. Everybody has a cellular phone. Everybody has a mobile phone. Everybody has a computer. Everybody had car. But this is not the real development, my friends. Where we are moving, and this threat. And Gandhi has seen all this threat, and he has written all these things in Hind Swaraj in 1909. You all know, if you will go through Gandhian ideas, the basic ideas, you have to read Hind Swaraj, which he has written in 1909 during the visit to South Africa to London. When he was returning from London to South Africa, he had written that book in Gujarati. And later it was translated in English and Hindi and in various languages. And he has, and all the original of idea of Gandhiji is explained in that small book, Hind Swaraj. And in that book, he has also discussed about the problems of this capitalism and the modern technology. Friends, I just want to say one or two things about modern technology and capitalism and about the idea, basic idea of Gandhiji, that he was in idea that if one person, yeah, one capitalist is having all the money and it creates the exploitation, discriminating, the inequality in the society, and it will hamper the social justice also and the liberty of the people also. And you can see at present time, the capitalists are so powerful that they can control the politics also. And the, even we are democratic country, even we are having a constitution, even then our member of parliament or member of legislative assembly, they are controlled, and the policy are being made for the not for the common man. The policy are made for the helping to the capitalist. Even you can see around 8 months, the farmers nearby Delhi, they are agitation, their movement is going on for their demand. They are demanding for maximum support price. Their demand is rightful, but still you can say any government, I am not blaming the present government. I am saying the general thing, and any party, any government which is being influenced by the capitalist, and their policies are being made in the favor of the capitalist, the industrialist, and that is against. If you are going through this seriously, then you will find that coming 20 years, we have adopted the globalization, and the bad impact of the globalization is that we are moving towards privatization. Every sector will be privatized, even education sector, and even not more than 10 or 15 years, all our central universities, all our government institutions will be in the hand of the private people, the capitalist, because the government policies is towards, we are moving towards the privatization. And if we are moving for the privatization, what will be the problem for the common man, the poor people, the aggrieved people, the last men of the society? They will not get proper education. The condition of that people will be very, very bad. We can say that worst condition should be there. So these are the apprehensions of Gandhiji, what he was saying in these things. And if you ask me, Dr. Pankaj, you are showing just the apprehensions of Gandhiji, so what is the solution? What is the solution? So I can say Gandhiji was not in the favor of big industries. He was not favor in the large scale industries. He was not favor in the production by the big machines. He was in the favor of the village people. He just want that self-sufficiency in the village. He was just against of mass production. He was not, he was in favor of small technologies, and which can be run in our villages also. And that is non-violent technology. He was not in the favor of that type of industry or machines that replaces the human labor. The reality is that, my friends, we are 140 crore people. We have enough human resources. In our country, what is the need of the human replacement by the machine? A few months back, I just go through the news channel, and it shows that in Bangalore, there is a restaurant. There is one restaurant is opened where all the waiters and managers are robots. And all robots are run by the artificial intelligence. And outside the restaurants, if you go outside the student, thousands of unemployed people are there. We are replacing human laborers. industrialization is good for the West because there is a crunch of human resources. But in our country, it is not needed. But in our country, it is not needed. That is the key point of Gandhiji. And where we have to think, where we have to revisit. And this is another another threat which I am going to show you. That is by Anthony J. Parel. Anthony J. Parel is a famous Gandhian thinker, and he has written three threat about three danger of the about the modern technology. He says that the first danger is the economic exploitation of less technologically advanced nations by the technologically advanced nation, and this is a question of justice. And really, it is happened when the countries. Hello, Sundar sir, I am. Am I audible, sir?
Yes.
Sundar sir,
you are audible.
Okay. My screen is showing, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. The screen is three dangers of modern technology.
Yes,
I am
yes.
So in this slide, the first danger which Anthony J. Parel want to say that the economic exploitation by the more advanced technologically advanced nation to the less technologically advanced nation. This is question of justice, which raised the question by the Anthony J. Parel. The second question is the threat is the impact of modern technology. Modern technology and by any means profit focusing on natural environment, and this question is it is a question of ecology. The first question was the question of justice, and the second question is a question of ecology. What we are doing, we are consuming the whole natural resources, friends. After 20-30 years, we don't have any petroleum, we don't have coal mines. All being will be will used by us. What will be the alternative? We have to think about the solar energy. We have to think about the another type of alternative energy. What we are doing? This consumerism and the artificial consumerism is danger for our ecology. And that is why, and the third question is about human liberty, a threat to the freedom to choose as a consumer. It encourages the compulsive consumption of unnecessary item. It is question of freedom. And it is by the media, visual media, the print media, we are being promoted. We are being inspired that we have to buy more and more things. That is not necessary, but still we are buying. And this is the question of freedom. And so we can say that this technology, what this technology is doing, that this technology, what are the basic dangers of them? They are questioning our justice, ecology, and liberty. And once Gandhiji said that I am not at all in the favor of machines that either make a handful of people poor by making many poor, or make a handful rich by unnecessarily displacing the useful labors of many peoples. And this is how correct it is. And today we are saying that this technology is replacing human labors. And this is another slide which I am showing, that about the technology, the production growth needed for rapid economic growth. And second, technological transformation needed, and human labor displacement and automated technology, and economic growth through production growth, but not employment. That means jobless growth. What we are seeing, the growth is, we are seeing the growth. Yes, the rich become more rich. Ambanis, Adanis, Birlas, Tatas, all the capitalists are become more rich. in last 2 years of pandemic, what we feel that we are feeling that they, the rich become more rich, and the lower middle class, and in the people of unorganized sector. Okay, so what we see, the famous eminent economist Vijay Shankar Sah tells us that this technology, what is technology had done, that economic growth in terms of database, in terms of the capitalist, we can say they are become more rich. But the real thing is that this all progress by replacing the poor one, replacing the human resource. And if this happens, so how can we develop? How can we become the third power of the world? And if this type of jobless growth is there, so how can we can say that we are progressing? After that, I am showing just the alternative. What is the alternative of this the technology? What is the alternative technology is? And in terms of Gandhiji, that we can. Sometimes I am disconnected. Friends, this is. This is the idea where which is against the higher technology, the Gandhi's idea of Swadeshi, and I will just go through the detail what is his idea of Swadeshi. And if you go through this slide, you can understand the what is the idea behind. Sir, I am visible and audible.
Yes, professor.
Sometimes my screen's out. That is why I.
Now the concept of Swadeshi. The slide is.
Concept of Swadeshi. Okay.
Yes.
And this is the basic idea of Gandhiji. And if we have to revisit the idea of Gandhi, we have to follow this path. This is the real idea that if there is a local need, so we will use local labor and we use local technology and local resources, and then only we can fulfill we can make the Gram Swaraj. You have heard about the idea of Gram Swaraj. That Gram Swaraj, the idea of Gram Swaraj is that the idea of Gram Swaraj is based on this. Our friends, in 21st century, we are talking about the smart cities. We are talking about we just want to make our Mumbai or Delhi just like Tokyo, but we are not thinking about our villages. If we are not thinking about our villages and we don't have the minimum facility of drinking water, after 70 years of independence, we don't have the proper pure drinking water facility in our villages. We don't have the sanitation facility. In 21st century, we are running a campaign, Swachh Bharat, Swachh Nya, and this is very, very sad, and this is very disappointing that we don't have the sanitation facility. The roads. Even so many areas are not connected with the cities. And still, and any government of after independence, I can say that any government has not worked for the in the long term plan. They are just thinking for the subsidy, and subsidy is not enough. We have to make a concrete plan for the common man, for the poor people. We have to think about how to give the employment to all the peoples of their skills, and we have to make that type of and in this slide I am going to say that globalization versus self-sufficient villages. And globalization means integration of world economic through cross-country exchange of goods, ideas, information, and many services. And dominant economics with aid, multinational companies and international organizations are serving their interests to the extent that often the interest of the poor countries is compromised. And globalization has led to the corruption of values and ethics, and also ruined the local identities. Gandhi was not against globalization, but would not have preferred the globalization in present sense. And this is the reality. Gandhi never accept this type of globalization, where and Gandhi has turned the globalization has turned the world into a global village, while Gandhiji wanted to promote a globe of villages. This is the difference. The global village, the whole world is now global village, but Gandhiji wants to promote a global village, globe of village. And he said that developing a village is to make self-sufficient and capable enough to develop itself against the world. And while globalization leads to acquisition of of wealth and in hands of few entities and lead to imperialism and to small village industries. My screen is not showing. The small village industries which Gandhi promoted would not have hoarded money to such an extent that they can dominate or donate to another. The village industries are still abiding by the Gandhian model of development. And the friends, the globe, he has all sort of thoughts for the Sundar sir, new slide is showing. Okay.
Cleanliness.
Yeah. And after so many thoughts, economic thoughts, I just come to the very recent one, the cleanliness. And one of the important aspect today, we are doing Swachh Bharat Abhiyan in the whole India, and this is also but Swachhata, that cleanliness is not physical cleanliness only, that not cleanliness the surrounding, the cleanliness that means that cleanliness means the inner cleanliness that is And it says that along with the clean roads and defection of free India, we also have to clean. Corruption-free society where transparency and accountability are cherished. We have just taken one aspect of Gandhi, that is outer cleanliness. This is most important, and really it is. We can thankful to the present governments that they are doing such things. But that is not enough. We have to looking to the physical cleanliness. We have to go through the outer cleanliness, inner cleanliness, and corruption-free society, and where the accountability should be fixed. And through the cleanliness drive, two of Gandhian principles are being fulfilled. truthfulness and cleanliness. And this is also related with the technology and modern development and modern technology and westernization of India. And we are moving, when we are talking about the heavy industries, modern civilization, and we are having when we say that we are now developed, we have a big car, we have big bungalow, and we have all sort of things. We have fridge, refrigerator, air conditioner. What we are doing? We are cutting trees and we're harming forest, and this type of development. What is the problem with this development? The problem is that we are destroying the ecological balance. And if ecological balance is, if we are not aware of this fact, friends, after some time, we have to think very seriously, because this is all over the world. We can see that the whole world is facing a certain type of environmental issues every time. And this is an alarming time if we can understand. And and again, in this, and United Nations, what United Nations says, that recognize the Gandhian principle of sustainable development, and inauguration of Gandhian solar park at United Nations headquarters is a testament to that. It is just a symbolic one, but we have to work on that. We have to think about different things, alternatives of the how we can protect our environment, how we can save our environment. If we can do it, we can really respect the Gandhian thoughts. And this is, after that, I can say ethical and moral values. And really, as our principal, Dr. K. Paul sir says, the truth and non-violence, satyagraha, sarvodaya, all these things are vital important in our life. And every day, and every parents, they are teaching to their children, and that we have to be honest, we have to be very disciplined, we have to be very ethical on our part. If we are doing so, we can say that we are really respecting the ideas of Gandhi. But the problem is that he initially, when we are in okay, and Gandhiji has also, and I can say I have not made any slide for another ideas, because there is sort of time, but I can say Gandhiji was the first man who has pulled out women's out of their houses, and this was the in a mass movement, and it was Gandhi. It was the first time that Gandhi who bring a woman outside of their houses, and he connected to the woman to the national movement, and it was a great achievement. And we can say Raja Ram Mohan Roy, Jyotiba Phule, and Ambedkar, and many more leaders are there, and Mahadev Govind Ranade, D.K. Karve, so many great leaders are there who worked for the women, E.V. Ramaswamy Nayakar, and many more leaders are there who have worked for the women empowerment. But the role of Gandhi was that women can also participate in Indian National Freedom Movement. Even today, we can say that if we rethink Gandhian thought, women can anything. Women can achieve all the things. But same thing is also apply on women, the ethics and the morality that is applicable to the last slide, which I am going to show you what we can learn from Gandhi and what we have to revisit. Friends,
Sundar Singh sir, I think sir is again facing the network issue.
Yes, network. Due to heavy rain, he is facing the trouble.
Yes, yes. We will wait for a minute.
Okay, sir.
One announcement for the dear participants, you can find the feedback link in the chat box. By filling up the feedback form, you will receive e-certificate.
Sorry, sir. Today I am facing a lot of problem because it's very outside in Sagar MP, it is heavy raining and my connection is very, very low. And I'm very extremely sorry to all of you, especially organizers. But just this last slide is most important because this is the crux of the whole Gandhian values, where we have to revisit that education without character. That is the Gandhi has given the more emphasis on this particular aspect, education without character. So we have to teach in school, in colleges, in universities, the most important thing, that is character, that is the moral values. If we have moral values, we can save our nation, we can progress our nation. If without this the character, we cannot do anything, we cannot be a good citizen. So important thing is that education is the most important, the key role. And second, the politics without principle. where we can say that today's poly, the principles, the morality in the politics, it disappears. We cannot say the politicians means the making machine of money. And today the politics of before independence and today's after independence has totally been changed. And this is most important. And commerce, that means business or trade or commerce, that is without morality. That is morality. This is also a deadly sin. It is said by Gandhi. And worship without sacrifice. If we are worshiping God, any God, sacrificing ourselves for the good of the human being and good for the, if you are not thinking about others, we are thinking about ourselves only, that we cannot progress, the country cannot progress. So the worship without sacrifice, this is the most important. Next one is the pleasure with consciousness. If we are conscious, if we are thinking about only ourselves, it is Gandhiji, and I have not touched this point, human labor and respect and dignity of labor. He has not have told about the dignity of labor, and he interconnected basic education and dignity of labor and education with skills. And today we are introducing new education policy and saying that this is Gandhian ideas. I don't think it is all about Gandhian ideas, but we can say that some thing have taken superficially from that idea. Not least, science without humanity. Science has two aspects, that it can create and it can destroy also. If we use science in our with the morality, with the ethical ground, then it can be used for the benefit of the humanity. But if we can, if we are doing in a wrong manner, that we can destroy. We have seen the Hiroshima and Nagasaki. We have also seen the First World War, Second World War. Every time, and we are facing the terrorism. We are facing the science with humanity, that we can progress. And this is, and all these are the seven deadly sins, which is said by Gandhiji. And
So
at last I can say, yes sir, sorry again, and last I can say, I can just I'm concluding my this lecture, and I don't know how to stop the sharing. Stop sharing. Okay. Yes. Thank you. Thank you, everybody. thank you for listening to me very patiently. And I'm apologizing and extremely sorry for the network issue. And because many times I have lost the connection. And thank you, everybody. And I'm thankful to Principal Sir, Dr. K. Paul Raj Sir, and all the respected guests and all the respected organizer and the coordinator, sir, and Dr. G.M. Sundar Singh, sir. And thank you for inviting me and giving me the wonderful chance. And all you people, I love to visit your college sometime whenever I will get time. And it is really wonderful experience with you. And if you have any questions, you can ask me. And I am there. If technology supports me.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for your wonderful presentation. Even though you have lost some network issues you faced, but you have presented in a systematic way. Really, you have systematically explained about truth, non-violence, Satyagraha, Sarvodaya, and highlighted the terms universal upliftment, progress of all, then serve the people, Swaraj, Swadeshi, then you have touched the population and poverty level, non-violence. I think you have touched a lot of the areas. And also you explained views on capitalism, technology, and other areas. And also you have explained the present situation of our country also. Lastly, you have touched the 7 deadly sins. So really, you have presented in a systematic way. It was very, very useful for us. And I think all the participants will be benefited from your talk, sir. Thank you. Thank you so much, sir. As our resource person said, it's the time for, it's the time for discussion and feedback. If anybody have questions, you can raise it now. Participants, you can unmute your mic and you can raise your questions. As well as my suggestion is, if not, you don't have any questions, please tell your feedback about the session. I request 1 or 2 participants, please express your feedback. Sir Sundar Singh, sir. Teachers also tell your feedback. If you're telling the feedback, the program will be colorful. Madam, HOD, madam.
So, HOD, ma'am, she will be telling the feedback.
Okay. Sir Sundar, sir, you can tell 1 or 2 verses.
Okay. Once again, good afternoon to you all. As the head of the Department of History, I'm very proud to recollect certain matters, especially today, the auspicious day. We are able to see directly Dr. Pankaj Singh, one of the eminent, reputed, the most personality of North India. Especially, I am very much connected with Madhya Pradesh. My sister and brother is there in Madhya Pradesh. After hearing those words of Dr. Pankaj Singh, how he is efficient to share up-to-date matters. Especially his views touch the hearts of everyone. I feel that the ruling or the administrative persons today just to visit this or hear this webinar means they will be very enthusiastic to come forward at least to think about the farmers' strike today. Delhi, it's crossed more than 100 days. The struggle based on Gandhian philosophy, Gandhian thought, that is non-violence, they are raising their cry. But no one is ready to listen. The administrators are keeping mum. They never worried about the ordinary people. So Dr. Pankaj Singh highlighted each and every activities what we should perform today. So due to time, unless I can share more than ever related to the presentation of Dr. Pankaj Singh, because right from the initiative of our father of our nation, Mahatma Gandhi, till today, why revisiting is essential? Why the term is given by the great personality, Dr. Pankaj Singh? We are every day, we are able to carry a lot of burden, but we never think about others' burden. But the great leader, the man of farsightedness, presented or highlighted or left edible points to think the present generation. We are proudly say that we are occupying so and so positions, but that present leaders never mind about the ordinary people. At least this message, that means that today's topic, revisiting Gandhian philosophy or Gandhian thoughts, should touch the hearts of the elite people. At least the persons attended the webinar benefited a lot, and we are going to carry the message to the youngsters. We are going to share with our youngsters. So the future leaders will adopt. Sir, Dr. Pankaj Singh, Professor, we are so thankful to you for sharing good views with us. Okay, thank you, sir, on behalf of the Department of History, where ideas and ideals, please share to the world again and again. Don't worry about what are the situation is going on in India. We should knock the door. Maybe Gandhi arrested many times, but we, especially the receiving a good breeze left by him. So please come forward to the nation as an youngster to spread the Gandhian views. I feel that you are an expert in Gandhian thoughts. Thank you, sir. Thank you all the professors and participants. Okay, thank you, thank you.
Thank you, madam. Thank you for your nice words, sir.
Dear professor, when we thought of fixing a program related with the webinar, the name which came to me in front is Dr. Pankaj Singh. When I contacted him, at first he refused. Though he was totally accompanied in Hindi belt, he told that it is somewhat impossible. But I insisted him, anyway, you have to give a talk related with the Gandhian thoughts. Really, your talk is motivating. What you have expressed in the lecture, the real fact which is happening in our country, you have expressed it in a clear manner. What are the troubles which are being faced, you have clarified it in a clear manner. The talk which you have given will be more useful for our future generation, the students, the research scholars. It will be more helpful to mainly to act the Gandhiji's policy in real life.
Thank you, Professor. Thank you for a wonderful speech. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Anybody else? Sundar Singh sir, shall we move to the next session?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, can.
Yes, let me welcome Evangelist Abel to propose vote of thanks. Madam, please, madam.
Very good afternoon to everyone. We have come to the last part of this webinar. It's a time to thank all the participants who presented in this webinar. First of all, I thank God Almighty for His grace and blessings to complete this webinar in a successful manner. Next, I thank the most honored correspondent of our college, Advocate L. Rajadurai, for his constant support and encouragement to this webinar. Next, I thank our most respected principal, Dr. K. Palraj. He is a source of inspiration in all the endeavors of our department. Sir, on behalf of the department and all the participants, I extend my wholehearted thanks to you. Next, I extend my thanks to the able, efficient, and dedicated HOD of our department, Dr. M. Glory Bai. She has taken a great initiative and gave great support to organize this webinar in the right time of independence. Madam, on behalf of all the participants, I express my wholehearted thanks to you. Our special and sincere thanks to the distinguished resource person of the today's webinar, Dr. Pankaj Singh, Assistant Professor of the Central University of Madhya Pradesh, who has spared his valuable time with us in sharing about the Gandhian thoughts. In spite of some interruption to the need of the hour, sir, your talk helped us to recollect the values of Gandhian thought, like truth, nonviolence, satyagraha, Swadeshi, Swaraj, women empowerment, and basic education, and so on. Really, your talk is very interesting and informative. You have given a very detailed account about the various concepts of Gandhian thought and how the life of Gandhiji influenced the great leaders of other countries. And your talk reveals that you are also a true follower of Gandhian principles. Really, given various facts, and your talk is very interesting, motivating, inspiring to all of us. Sir, on behalf of the Department of History of NMCC College, I express my wholehearted thanks to you. Next, I express my thanks to the young and energetic assistant professor of our department, Dr. D.M. Sundar Singh, the organizing secretary of this webinar, who has taken tireless effort to organize this webinar in a successful manner. Thank you, sir. I also thank Dr. R. Edwin Sam, who served as the moderator of this webinar. I thank all the faculties, members of the Department of History for the wholehearted support. I express my thanks to the IQSC coordinator, Professor T.B. Thomas, and his team for the technical assistance. I express my sincere thanks to all the participants. Your presence has made this webinar a great success. I thank all the faculty members of various departments of our college, various reputed institutions, research scholars, UG and PG students, friends and well-wishers from all over India. Thanks to one and all. On this occasion, let us all take a pledge to follow the footsteps of Mahatma Gandhiji, the great soul, the symbol of peace and non-violence, and make the 21st century a peaceful one. By following his ethics, we can shape the world in a gentle way. Thanks to one and all.
Thank you, madam. Thank you for your wonderful vote of thanks. Once again, I thank one and all. As Gandhi ji said, the future depends on what you do today. do good things for our nation, follow Gandhian principles, make good nation. Thank you one and all.
Okay, I think we can conclude the session.